Hi, I'm Jonathan, an artist from Germany. For over a year I've been creating tutorials for 3D graphics in Blender, and now I finally stopped. In last week's video I've already talked about it, but I thought before we get into this week's updates, I'll give you a quick rundown of what I mean by that and my thought process. Creating tutorials is great, it's fun, but in the long run it limited me in working on bigger projects, and that's where this content change comes in. Just like in the popular devlog format, I'll start documenting my weekly progress in almost vlog-like videos. To do this best, I started streaming. You can find all the recordings in the stream playlist. This week started pretty slow. With the thought of being able to do anything I wanted, I organized my streaming setup, meaning I needed a facecam and some things to work on. So, together with my friend Leo, I started streaming on Tuesday. Because I was using the NDI OBS plugin to stream from my second, older PC, I ran into some audio troubles. This way, the whole experience was pretty chaotic and overall a big mess. Luckily, I managed to fix everything, so on Thursday I was able to stream for about 1.5 hours without interruptions. During both of these streams, I fixed some node issues with the screen material, meaning the tiling is now done a lot more efficient. In last week's video, I showed you how I used an old node group I found online to procedurally tile a pixel, but luckily a viewer of mine informed me about this little setup, which also allows us to tile procedurally, but it instantly works in all quarters. The only problem was that I needed object coordinates ranging from -1 and -1 to 1 and 1. And the tiling only works from 0,0 to 1 and 1. But luckily, with some tweaking, I was able to get the result I wanted. We can just use a subtract node and subtract 0.5 on both the x and y axis. The only problem now was that if I connected it to the vector input of the pixel, it doesn't work as expected. This is due to the subtraction. But the easiest fix was to use a multiply node and multiply it by 2 on both the x and y axis. And now you can see we can easily tile our pixel node group. And the setup works basically for everything. We could even plug in a noise texture and it would tile. Of course, you can download the updated file on Gumroad. In between streams, I also managed to finish up the node alphabet I used in the thumbnail of last week's video. Creating this was actually a pretty fun exercise. Because for this I chose an 8-bit font, I only had to work with rectangles. This made everything a lot easier than I thought. Of course, you can go to my Gumroad page and also download this file, but I will quickly show you what I've done. Let's for example preview the M. You can see that I've added a value slider to switch between a tall and thin version. If I enter the node group, you might be intimidated by all of these nodes, but this is actually pretty easy. All of these small groups that are being either subtracted or added together in the end are different shapes making up our N. This, for example, is the initial square that defines the boundaries. To cut off this part, I just used another rectangle right here. In these update videos, I won't go in depth into how I achieve these things. If you have any questions, you can always ask them in the comments, or again, just download the notes yourself. The fun part was implementing this slider. You can see that ranging between 0 and 1, it stays tall, and exactly on 1, it switches to the small version. I basically used a less than node with a threshold of 1 to switch between white and black when the value hits 1. Using this as a factor, I can mix two combined XYZ nodes together that control the overall shape. If you think this is useful, I might even spend some time on stream creating other fonts. So, let me know in the comments. But of course, with this content change, I wanted to take on bigger projects. So on Thursday's stream, I started work on a little app together with Leo. You can find his channel in the video description. We were planning on creating a Stream Deck app that allows you to switch scenes in OBS with Dart, Python and Blender for 2.5D visuals, like buttons and the background. Because I have never worked with Firebase and Firestore, I used most of the time rumbling along while trying to connect to our database. it looks really weird. I'm gonna just get you on my second screen.
Yeah, I'm doing that too.
It was quite fun talking to you, but frankly, I did not get much done except a few lines of code and an initial sketch for the icons. We will hopefully continue work next week and stream our progress to both of our channels. Yeah, basically just a nice color and shadows and everything looks good. I spend the rest of the week with school and making music. I'm hoping to use these tracks in upcoming projects, but we'll see. And with that, I want to end this video. Over the next days and weeks, I will further improve these types of videos. In the end, I'm planning on giving in-depth looks into personal projects and creating almost story-driven content. So if you don't want to miss all of that, consider subscribing, and we will see us in my next stream or video next Saturday.